Cari amici ascoltatori, on March 30th, 1913, a son was born to Mr. and Mrs. Lovecchio, who were immigrants from Montreal in Sicily. And they were living in Little Italy section of Chicago at the time. The baby was named Francesco Peter Lovecchio. And for 20 years or more, he tried many ways to earn a living. He was a marathon dancer and performed in Atlantic City, where he won. And his record of over 5,000 hours still stands. He knocked around for some 20 years and moved to Los Angeles. He loved music. And his two favorite singers, I'm told, were Caruso and Carlo Butti. So he began singing in local cafes. One night, Frank Lovecchio was singing a Hoagie Carmichael song, The Rocking Chair. And who was in the audience, and Mr. Lovecchio didn't know anything about it, but Hoagie Carmichael. He loved the way the song was being sung and became good friends with Frank Lovecchio. But it wasn't until 1946 when Mr. Lovecchio sang this song that his stardom shot up into the heavens and keeps going higher and higher. The most recognizable styles and song in the world of music. Cari amici, say hello to my guest, Mr. Frankie Laine. Buon pomeriggio, Frankie.
How are you?
I'm wonderful. How are you, Mr. Laine? What's happening out there in San Diego?
I was trying to think of the name of the song that the name of the picture that I did with Tony Arden.
Oh, a Rainbow Around My Shoulder.
Rainbow Around My Shoulder.
That's what you did.
Yeah.
I'm glad I remembered.
I couldn't think of it.
How have you been doing in these past couple of warm years?
Well, I'm old enough now so that I'm mumbling the words and screw it up a little bit.
No, you don't. I saw you a couple of Saturdays ago on public TV sing the very same song. You were dressed in red, and you hit every note clear as a bell. And yeah. I thought that was fantastic. That's the night I got up, I got on the phone, and I called your lovely wife, Marcia, and made this appointment.
Some of the songs come out all right, and some of them don't.
Well,
you know, age sneaks up on all of us.
You're telling me. I can't remember if I put on my pants this morning. But tell me, you started this career, was helped along by the great, the one and only Hoagy Carmichael.
Well, it's funny, because this guy came running up to the stage after I finished, and he said, what's your name? I told him, and he says, where are you working? I says, I'm not. And he says, come with me. So he took me up to meet Billy Berg himself.
Oh, yeah, that was the band leader. That was the owner of the cafe.
Yeah, and I knew Billy better than I knew him. And he said, I want you to meet Billy. And that was the night that Billy put me to work.
Yeah.
And I knew Billy better than I knew him. And he said, why don't you put this kid to work? And he sings great. And Billy says, what for? He comes in and sings every night for nothing.
Now he had to pay you.
And now he had to pay me.
And the song that you sang that night, that Hoagy Carmichael, was Rocking Chair, which was a Hoagy Carmichael song.
That's right. And no, that's right. It was Rocking Chair.
Right. And I that was a great song. And then from there, it went on to 21 gold hits. I told a lot of people in the past couple of weeks that you were going to be on. And each time I say, you know, Frankie Laine is coming on, every single one I spoke to all said the same. My goodness, he was my favorite singer. I loved. And then they would go through a whole ritual of your songs. And, oh, he sang this and he sang that. I told them, I know. I'm interviewing the guy. I know what he sang. But, that says a lot about a person. Then you went into the movies. And from Mercury Records, you went to Columbia Records.
Mm-hmm.
And that was with Mitch Miller.
Mitch Miller.
Yeah. And you had a lot of hits in Mercury. I loved all the hits that you had there. But you changed your name from The Elder, which is Lorecchio, to Frankie Laine. Is there a story behind that? Did you do that yourself or somebody did it for you?
Well, I was helped by Jack Coombs, and he was the station manager, and it happened that the girl that took my secretary's place, she passed away, and the girl that took her place is then Mary Jo Coombs.
Uh-huh.
And why it's happened, I'll never know. It just occurred.
Yeah.
And she helped me. He helped me figure out the song, figure out the name.
Oh, I see. There was a whole slew of you guys at that time. There was Gennaro Vitagliano, which is Jerry Vale, Aldo Gismondi, Alan Dale, Connie Francis, Concetta Franconero.
Yeah.
And a friend of mine and a friend of yours from the movie we spoke about before, Antonetta Addicioni. And we know her as Tony Arden. So they all changed their names from the old style, and yours became out Frankie Laine. Now, did you have any brothers and sisters while you were living in Chicago?
Four brothers and two sisters.
Wonderful.
But, never got into the business.
No. And did you speak Italian at home? Your parents were from Italy. You did?
Yeah.
They were from Montreal in Sicily.
Montreal.
Yes, in near Sicily, near Palermo. And
very near Palermo.
Right.